Sometimes the way that I'm feeling inside doesn't show, but I know I'll get over you. I've just got a long way to go. I'm still under the weather, but I'm over the storm, and I still miss the shelter of you. Was lesson number two. I can't lie, baby, I still cry sometimes. But I've come a long way towards getting you out of my mind. I'm still under the weather, but I'm still miss the shelter of your loving arms. But what I thought would kill me has just made me strong. I'm still under the weather, but I'm
Marlene and Keegan, we want to thank God that this special day, this day is special for them. We want to just give God all the praise. Can we bow our heads for a moment? Father God, we want to bless you and honor you. We want to thank you this time that we are able to invite you into our presence. We want to ask you in that wonderful and special name of our Lord Jesus Christ in this couple's life. We want to ask you that you would, Lord, allow your blessing, the blessing that maketh rich and addeth no sorrow, to be released over their life. We say thank you for family and friend that is here today to share in this wonderful day of them. Yes, Lord, we ask you in Jesus' name that you would bless the ceremony in a way that your name can be glorified. For we ask in your name, amen. You may be seated. This couple's life today, we pray God's blessing over them. I'd like to share with you, and with them in particular, a few scriptures out of the word of the Lord as I believe Marlene and Keegan took you a long time to make this decision. But by the grace of God, you are here today, and I know that you don't make light of it, and you never would want this marriage to become another statistic that it failed and been gone through the sadness of a separation. I want to read to you a scripture that for me spells out, and if you can embrace the words that I share with you today, it will ensure that not only the blessing of God on your life, but you will also enjoy prosperity, and you will have a healthy and a godly home and relationship. The Bible, God instituted marriage. Marriage is a God thing to begin with. It's not a simple decision made between two people. You choose. You have made the choice for each other, and God will honor it. You know, when Adam and Eve went wrong and things didn't turn out right for them, it was Adam that said to God, "It's the wife you gave me." And ever since then, he left the choice for a man and a woman. And when you make a choice, he honors it and he blesses. But he also gives you word in the fear of God. Now, normally, the men only remember the latter part. But ask any of these senior people that are married for a few years, they will tell you that marriage is give and take. It's never unbalanced and a one-sided affair. Nonetheless, God has got certain principles that if we adhere to it, it will bring blessing. And he addresses the wives like this. Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, just as the church is subject to Christ, so let the wives be to their husbands in everything. Not certain things, you as his wife, to obey their husbands in everything. Just as Christ, the church is subject to Christ, cannot function without Christ because he's the head of the church. Eve, we've seen Adam's need of a companion in life. Another scripture in the Bible says, a man that finds a wife finds a good thing. It's never intended for a man to be without a spouse in life. God ordained it, he created, he made us with our emotions, our feelings, our desires for the opposite sex. It's a God thing. And so God, if you embrace his word, Marlene, when situations perhaps get bigger than you and you don't know what to do, remember today, if you honor his word, you can turn to him with a confidence and say, "Lord, I remember what was said when we got married. This problem is a bit bigger than me. Won't you help me?" He's obliged to do it. There's very few things that God's obliged to do, but we all want to do that for those that honor his word. Then he says something totally different to a husband. And this is what it says, Keegan. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of the water by the word, that he may present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. For he who loves his wife loves himself. When I read something about wives submitting to your own husbands, never said or mentioned the word love. And I always wondered, how can God ask us as men to love our wives as he loved the church? It seems almost impossible. And then you ask yourself, but how did he love the church? Scripture says he loved the church unconditionally. Today there are many people that have committed their lives to the Lord and are serving him. And that's a great blessing. But even then, how do we love? How are you going to express his kind of love towards your wife, Marlene? It's first of all an unconditional love. A love that doesn't depend on what she will give in return or do in return. Scripture says he loved us while we were yet sinners. While we were still out there lost, without God, without hope, he loves us. And then also he loves us sacrificially, to a point where he was willing to give his life for his bride, the church. You see, Keegan, the responsibility of being the head is not easy. Because the reality is, God wants you to be king, priest, and prophet in your home. King to rule, not with a rod of iron, but to rule with love, as Christ loves us, unconditional and sacrificial, expecting nothing else in return. When you are the head, you're not only a ruler of your home, and God holds you accountable and responsible for the welfare of your wife and your family. When I say you are supposed to be a prophet and a priest, a prophet is not a fortune teller. A prophet is not a sangoma or somebody rolling the stones. A prophet in the eyes of God is simply somebody committed to God who shares with his wife and the oracles of God to teach and to show them the way of the Lord. To be a priest means something different. While a prophet shares God with the family, as being the priest, it's your privilege to bring your family to God, to pray God's protection, to pray God's providence, to pray God's blessing over your home and your family. So it's not just as we would normally think, I'm the head, she's the tail. No, it's far from that. There's responsibility. And God will hold you responsible as to how you will look after your family. Now I said, how can he ask us something? By his grace, God enables us. Or else he would never have said it to begin with. He enables you. And you need to know him. Learn to know him. Learn to trust him. My late wife used to always say, Stan, when you share the wedding vows with With couples, you need to add this other phrase, not only for better or for worse, but also for fatter or thinner. Because she's never going to look the same in the years to come. She's going to change. You're going to change. Yeah? So, but it's an important thing. Old together. My prayer is that God will bless you. There will be times, ask any married man, there will be times when you don't understand. You won't understand what's going on in the heart or in the mind, it's different. But again, like she has a privilege. When you take serious your responsibility, again, God is obliged to work in her heart in a way that you can't. He knows how to help us. And so my prayer is that God will bless you, that God will enable you. And as a couple, you know, whenever you do something for God, it demands our best, isn't it? So if you're giving your best to her and she likewise giving her best to you, you got a formula that is destined to make your marriage in your lives and in your home. You know, a home that is truly committed doesn't know. There's always needs. David said these words, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." To want will always be there, but God knows how to provide our needs. And so I pray that God bless you, that as you listen to His word, may you be encouraged and inspired to live the kind of life that will bring joy, happiness, fulfillment, and contentment for the years that God may spend. Amen. God bless you. I'm going to ask this. And I have to raise the woman and ask you to stand. We want to thank you, Lord, for Keegan and Marlene that is about to exchange and make a lifelong commitment one to another. They will also give, Lord, and receive from each other these rings. I pray, Lord, that these rings will forever be a reminder to them of the day when they stood before God and man and they made a declaration to each other. I pray, Lord, that you bless these rings, and we will never forget to give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. For we pray and ask it with thanksgiving. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. I need to get to see this after me. I, Keegan Wade Michaels, call upon all ye present to witness in the presence of God that I take Marlene Nicole Singh. That I take Marlene Nicole Singh, whose hand I now hold, to be my lawfully wedded wife. To have and to hold. To love and to cherish. For richer or poorer. In sickness or in health. For better or for worse. And to withhold myself from all others. As long as we both shall live. Thank you. I'm Arlene Nicole Singh.
I'm Arlene Nicole Singh.
Call upon all ye present.
Call upon all ye present.
To witness in the presence of God. To witness in the presence of God.
To witness in the presence of God.
That I take. Keegan Wade Michaels. Whose hand I now hold, be my lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold, to love and to cherish, for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, and to withhold myself from all others, as long as we both shall live. I'm going to ask us to kneel and we're going to pray for you. We'll pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for the couple kneeling before you today. You've listened to them exchanging and making a vow and a commitment to each other. And sealing it, Lord, with the giving and receiving of a ring. I pray and ask you now in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, that Lord, you'd allow the triune blessing of God to be their portion. That you bless them, Lord, with a blessing that maketh rich and addeth no sorrow. That Lord, their union and their life, I pray, Lord, that you bless them, bless their home. I pray that you bless their going and their coming, their sitting and their rising. Help them to know the God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Jacob. The God, Lord, that would never fail, that has assured us, I will never leave you, nor will I forsake you. Allow them to put their faith, their trust, and total confidence in you for the rest of their life. We pray and ask it with thanksgiving. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Now for that very special moment, the groom may kiss his bride. My privilege to introduce to you today Mr. and Mrs. Keegan Michaels. Yeah. Sunday. Let us stand for the benediction of Jesus Christ, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, rest and abide with everyone until Jesus comes, and we all say, Amen.
Amen.
Bridal couple, together with the entourage, are going to make their way to take some photos. Together with the parents, and the guests can be seated outside.
Spirit, we desire.
Guys, thanks very much. I think we all can agree that we've got a lovely couple here.
How can we be lovers if we can't be friends? How can we start over when the fighting never ends, baby? How can we make love if we can't make amends? How can we be lovers if we can't be friends? Look at us now.
Everybody can just bear in mind that we've got small children running around. I'd ask all the parents, please guys, just keep your kids close to you. We don't want anybody getting hurt. Towards the end there's the gents and the ladies. If you go through the door at the back, then the bar is at the back as well. Please note that you are not allowed to smoke in this venue. If you want to smoke, you can go out. As you can see, the exits on the left and to the right. So if you do need to take a smoke break, I ask you guys to go out and take cutlery, please. The cutlery is for eating. Don't take it home also. Again, as our next is Hana ABC2. Leave the cutlery. All the other things here, it's all the wedding venues stuff. Marla and Keegan will be giving out some souvenirs later on. And I think compliments of both of them. If you feel under your chair now, there's what? That's next week. Experiment. That's next week. I see that the colored wedding. Can you see? You put that on net, no come. Okay, so guys, without further ado, we had a very. I cannot let the words was quiet. I don't know. Elegant. We had a very elegant establishment. If I can ask Uncle Richard to please come and open up in prayer for us.
Shall we all bow our heads in prayer? Father, we come to you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you, dear God, for the gift of life and for the gift of love, for two young people who have found each other. We thank you, Almighty God, that you've been gracious to them, you've been merciful to them. And we thank you that on this day they can celebrate their union in the midst of all of us. Father, as we celebrate with them this evening, we pray that you will descend on this venue, that you will bless all the proceedings here this evening. Everything that will be said, I think especially of the two families.
Provence me the evening. Look for the sectoral corpus in the airport. As your problems here, we have a problem in the Kalmar and Sophia. We know the men's, the better men's, and the other evening can bring us to hand in the rest of the world. That's what
I can ask Keegan's dad and say a few words.
Hello. Good evening, everybody.
Good evening, teacher.
I welcome each and everyone in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Like Mala said, things went a little bit hectic. I wrote out a speech. I don't know where it is. I tried again, and I wrote something there. But now I'm called to the front, you know. And in my position, you know, as a teacher, you always expect the children to be prepared. Now I know what they are going through. Ladies and gentlemen, please bear with me. Glenn said, I mean, a marriage is a partnership. And in this partnership, we have certain expectations of each other. But most of all, in this partnership, you can't walk alone. This marriage, or this this marriage is a partnership, and in this marriage, your partner, your main partner, will be God. And without God, you can't take on this journey. In, on this journey of marriage, you know, when you marry, you will go through ups and downs, you will get your stop streets, you will get your crossroads, you will have uphills, downhills, but with God alongside you as your navigator, your partner, you won't get lost like most of the guests got lost today, depending on a piece of paper and hoping if I phone the next person, he will tell me how to get it. No. Make God part of your plan. Before you get married, make God part of your plan. When you marry, he should be part of that plan. I brought something with me, you know, a special gift for Mala and Egan. We received a map. Now, this partnership and this marriage, I brought a map for them, you know. And like I said, God is part of your plan. He's part of your marriage. And this map that I brought with me, we call the Bible. And if they use this Bible in their relationship, in their marriage, they will never be lost. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for being here. I hope you have a wonderful evening. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to witness this map. I've given it to them. It's for a couple. If they do not use it,
before I call the next two, I think I'm going to need Phoenix because I know Mona is a bit emotional. Thanks for that. But Keegan, I mean, I've been married a couple of years, so I think I'm in a position to give you some. I think I'm in a position to share some of my wisdom, and I've got lots of gray hair, so that encourages me as well. So I think in marriage, Keegan, there's four rings. I was there when you guys got engaged. So that was the first ring. You just saw the second ring now, the outside. That's the wedding ring. But the other two rings. So the other ring, you're going to go through it. And I'm going to say to Mala, you know, a good wife always forgives her husband when she's wrong. So you go through that. When you're married, the wife is always right. So the next ring is suffering. And after the suffering, it's enduring. So like your dad said, there you've got the map. So if you can please welcome. Okay, welcome.
Evening, everyone. Firstly, they got married. I signed for my sister. And I didn't congratulate them as yet. But I'd just like to congratulate the two of you. And I'm seriously going to miss the two of you, even though all of us fight all the time. But I'm going to miss you. I just want to say congratulations and God bless.
And then if I can ask one of Keegan's good friends, I think you guys have been friends for over 10 years now. That's you. That's you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Keeks,
We've known each other for about 10 years now. You're still the same person I know from back then. I'd like to tell you I really appreciate being in this wedding. It means a lot to me and being on yours. But I'd like to give you some tips, if I can. Like the part of the scene of the house, I'd just like you to carry that forward in your home with your family and keep in touch that God is always with you guys through the end. So everything will be okay and God bless you. Thank you.
Show it all the time, but she really does appreciate it. So my friend, I'm going to say congratulations.
You're the first one of us that got married.
I'll always love you. To Keegan, I want to say, you don't become one until you're a union, until you have the covenant of God. Yes, you guys went through a relationship, a very long relationship, but only now you guys are a union. Only now you guys have become one in the eyes of God. And the covenant of God is strong and it should be held sacred and it should be held just for the two of you. I want to say thank you so much for having me in your wedding. Thank you for trusting me as being your maid of honor, sharing with Flora. You guys have always been my sisters and you always will, and I love you guys very much.
Thank you, Kia. I think the next person, I'm not sure how to pronounce your name.
Keegan and Mala, the truest meaning of marriage is the magic of being needed by just one person. The two of you have come together to share your love, to share your lives and realize your dreams. Today you are husband and wife. This is one day of great adventure, and I'm proud and honored to be able to share it with you. Remember that great opportunities we have which are the seldom comes, but smaller ones will surround you every day. I toast to the two of you and wish you a long marriage filled with love and laughter. Thank you.
I can see you stressing there, so compose yourself. Let me give you a story while you think about all the nice things you're going to say to your wife. Don't forget she's your wife, you know what I mean? No worries. So, word that I want to give you guys is be a frog in your marriage. Now, Ashton likes the Eiffel Tower. And they went, everybody gathered, and the frog started climbing. And as they were climbing, some of the people came together and they were looking at all these frogs climbing up the Eiffel Tower. And people said, you know what, these guys are never going to make it to the top. And as they were saying that, the frogs started dropping. So as they went higher, more and more frogs started dropping. Until eventually there was only one frog left. And all the people said, you know what, that frog's not going to make it to the top. There's no way you can make it. But lo and behold, he made it right on the top. When he got down, all the other frogs said to him, dude, of all the frogs here, you're the only one that made it to the top. How did you manage to do this? The frog just kept on hopping or walking or doing whatever. And they're like, what's up with this frog? And one of the guys said, hey, that guy's deaf. So the moral of the story is, when in your marriage, don't listen to the negative things that people are saying. Because people's always going to say things about, there's people that say things about the wedding also. But people are always going to say things. And if you're going to listen to those negative things, like the other frogs, you tend to fall. So my advice to you guys is, when the negative things come, be careful to them.
because it's just between the two of you. Kids, God yours, boy.
Firstly, I want to say thank you to all our family members, close friends, work colleagues for being here today to celebrate with Mali and I this joyous occasion. I'd also like to say thank you to my mother and father-in-law, Antonia and Uncle Glenn, my father and mother as well, Anthony and Jennifer. My best friend.
Guys, if I can just ask, let's just have a bit of order here. If I can ask, if I just stop with the popping of the champagne and whatever, I think what Tina has to say is important. So let's just get some order here. Thank you, guys.
Guys.
Where was I? I'd like to say thank you. I was really fortunate not to just have one best man. I've had best men because all of them helped me in their own way. Nathaniel, Brian, Myra, Saber, John T, and the ghost best man, Wiggies. The caterer, the florist, Danny Boki. I'm also fortunate to have a lot of mothers. Boki is one of them. Antel, Jane. Audrey and Jenna just enjoy yourself and be safe. And I'd also like to say thank you to Mali, my wife. To me, she motivated me in ways you won't believe. I just want to say thank you, my wife. I like the way that song goes. And stay as beautiful and humble and as sweet as you are. I love you all. Okay, so not too much more. If I can ask, you okay there, Brian? Good. So if I can ask Brian, if everybody can stand, we're about to do the toast now.
So can you on your
party? I'd like to propose a toast to my old booty and Mala, my sister-in-law. I wish you many more years. Stay strong and stay with people that you love. Thank you for everybody that came. So, say cheers.
Thank you. We come in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ this evening. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, for supper that we can have tonight. I pray, Lord Jesus, that you will bless each and every hand that prepared the supper tonight, my Father, my God. I pray that you will bless this food to our bodies. I pray that our bodies will be at service to thee, O Lord. And Father, Lord God, tonight we will not forget those who does not have. I pray, Father, that you will bless them also. And I pray, Father, Lord Jesus, for when we eat, that there be order after eating. In Jesus' name, we pray with much thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
My heart, I feel the same old laughter glow. name is Glenn Hendricks. I'm the father of the bride.
Okay.
Yes. I feel very happy. I'm actually proud. You know, as my daughter, I must feel proud of her because she's done everything I asked her to do. I think this is the final stage of to get married. I've always said if they get married and they stay together, there's no problem. But they cannot stay together. She knows it. I'm a proud father today that my daughter get married. My wish is for them to, as parents, as a mother and a father, to let the children grow up in the house of the Lord, in the church. That is my wish. For them to have everything the best that they want. Yeah, I'm very happy. Seriously, I'm very, very happy.
Thank you very much.
Okay, pleasure.
The light is bright here.
Bright,
I'm Nathaniel Van Dyk, the best man. It's a wonderful evening. I'm honored to be the best man. I'm actually thankful that you asked me. Thank you for that.
Shannon, Gloria, celebrate the union. They actually family to me. We actually grew up, they grew up before me. Mala became a sister to me and Keegan a brother. I'm very happy for them and I know they're gonna have a great marriage together. A wish for them is to be happy and for them to achieve everything that they want to achieve. Don't see me. Oh, and Keegan, you finally married the right face, so they'll stop confusing me and Mala now.
Talk about love. Talk about trust. Talk about forever, baby. When you talk about us, I give you my word. I stick to my guns. Believe me when I tell you, baby, and we just begun. You don't understand. I'm gonna be
talk about love, talk about trust, talk about forever, baby. When you talk about us, I give you my word, I stick to my guns. Believe me when I tell you, baby, and we just begun. You don't understand.
Yeah.
Thank you.